Chief Financial Analyst, basically leading the costing team for the trust delivery patient level costing service landing party. I started as a regional financial management trainee, graduate trainee, in the West Midlands in 1993. And that was in the days before the scheme was national. What I found was that I was getting interviews for positions, but obviously there was a high demand for a large number of jobs. And even though I was getting the interviews, I wasn't successful. Now, whether that was down to people not wanting to take a risk employing a disabled person, you can't say, but certainly it felt like that in some cases, and did sometimes feel like a barrier. I think the key point when discussing disability in the context of diversity and inclusion is that people with disabilities might have a label, might be labelled as having one or more disabilities that will be things people have heard of. So cerebral palsy, deafness, blindness, autism, but no two people with a disability will be the same or face the same challenges or have the same needs. And so there's no one rule fits all. And it's really key, especially when addressing issues of disability, to see the individual first and work with them to overcome any challenges that they face in the workplace. In general, I don't think having a disability has hindered my career progression, but there's certainly aspects that affect me on a day-to-day basis. What I find is it's not the big adjustment, it's the little thing that can be frustrating. So, carrying your hot cup of tea from the kitchen or be able to walk from the car to the office if that is the outside. And I don't think there are things that you can really make reasonable adjustment. You rely on colleagues to assist you. And what I found is if I ask for help, colleagues are more than willing to assist. And I think if you have a disability, if you're working with a disability, you've got a commitment to explain what you need to your colleagues. And if you're open and honest with them, they're usually more than willing to help with that. So, physical barriers I don't find hard to overcome, but unfortunately I still come across examples in the workplace where people judge based on maybe more my speech or my movement. They make the judgment about my mental capacity. And that can be frustrating or upsetting, depending on the circumstances. What I find is that in the main, it's usually people that I'm meeting for the first time that don't know me, or that I'm just meeting incidental to the role. Although I was the one blatantly patronised by a chairperson for the trust I was working in, which, yeah, so there are still some challenges out there. Attitudes have changed in the 25 years that I've worked in the NHS. And I think attitudes have changed in the NHS and wider. And I think people are more accepting of people with disabilities. I think one example for me is that I know that I am a good communicator despite my speech impediment. Back to the fact that not how I say something, what I say. That's what I felt my career should develop as, and I persevered to achieve that. I've been privileged to stand up and deliver a number of presentations, workshops, even day-long facilitation events to costing professionals about the HFMA Costing Professional Institute. And I feel that I get a real buzz out of doing that, but also I am doing my bit for diversity in leading those, because people are seeing somebody with a speech impediment in a senior role who's confident to stand up and present on a subject they know about. I've avoided any disability type networks throughout my career, really, until I got involved recently with the FFF Diversity Delivery Group. The reason I got involved though with the FFF Diversity Group is because that group looking specifically at how to develop staff to grow in their careers and to be given those opportunities regardless of whether they've got what called a protected characteristic. And I really like that positive approach to diversity. Take every opportunity to try new things and progress, even if it goes outside the realms of your job description. Main advice is don't be overwhelmed by rejection and setbacks. Persevere. Know your own strength and keep pushing to achieve what you want to achieve. That's certainly what I meant to do.